our first edition of Android Setup Wars, we'll be giving away a brand new LG G6 to one of the top 6 entries to the Android Setup Wars. Since I couldn't decide who should win the LG G6, we will simply do a random drawing between the top 6 qualifiers to the Android Setup Wars. If you missed our first Android Setup Wars, you can enter our next Android Setup Wars where we'll be giving away a Pixel 3. The first entry comes from user MadeX. He has a Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus SMG955FT dual SIM Exynos model running the latest TeamExyKings Lite ROM, which is an S9 ROM. He has successfully converted his Galaxy S8 Plus into a full-fledged S9 Plus through the use of a custom ROM. His Galaxy S8 Plus also has a dual speaker mod so he can enjoy stereo sound along with Dolby Atmos, both which come with the custom ROM. MateX is planning to remap his Bixby button to something more useful, as the custom ROM has an option to remap to other things like Google Assistant or the camera. His SA Plus is also running the TGP kernel, a custom kernel that improves the battery life over the default kernel that comes with the ROM. Overall, I would have to say this is certainly high on Android. While many people are not too keen on custom ROMs, user X has proved to us that he has taken his Galaxy S8 Plus to a whole another level with a custom ROM and a custom kernel along with new S9 features with the S9 ROM. Two thumbs up, baby. The second entry comes from user Jamani. Jamani has turned his Galaxy S9 into a full-fledged laptop using Samsung DeX on a HP Lapdock. According to Jamani, as a student, I needed a good phone, nothing better than a Note 9 for taking notes. I needed a laptop like a Chromebook, but a little more premium and more than just a web browser. I needed these things on the cheap because I am a poor high school student. The solution was Samsung DeX. After doing some research, I could use the Enterprise Windows phone to laptop device, the HP Lapdock with the Note 9 DeX. HP Lapdock is a device initially built for Windows smartphones that allows them to be used as laptops. It features a 1080p 12.5-inch display, backlit keyboard, B&O speakers, and weight of only 2 pounds. While HP Lapdock is not designed for use with Samsung smartphones, you can use it by connecting a USB Type-C cable and you'll be able to use the screen, keyboard, and trackpad on the HP Lapdock and fully convert your Note 9 into a laptop. This is definitely a great idea to convert your existing Galaxy Note 9 into a portable laptop. Definitely some creative thinking from a poor high school student that will save him a bunch of money on a new laptop. I don't think this will be the best laptop out there, obviously, but for the purposes of typing on a larger screen with portability, this is an excellent idea. The third entry comes from Lefteris, who says, I'm using Samsung S7 Edge with latest Batman ROM. Root it using your guide. My main launcher is Nova Prime. I have Zooper widget and some custom animations and shortcuts to make my everyday use a personal custom experience. Themed from Samsung Store, wallpaper from Zedge, custom notification titles using Tiles app. This is another example of a user who is able to upgrade an aging smartphone software himself by rooting, installing custom ROM, and using custom launchers and widgets. While I am personally guilty of not using enough aftermarket launchers and widgets, this is a perfect example of how you can easily update your phone and customize it. The fourth entry comes from Dan, who has the ultimate PUBG mobile setup using a OnePlus 2. His OnePlus 2 is connected to an LCD monitor wirelessly via Chromecast, and also it is cooled by a laptop cooler. His OnePlus 2 is running the Pixel Experience ROM, which also converts his OnePlus 2 into a Pixel 3 with Gravity kernel that allow him to overclock his CPU from 1.7 GHz to 2.2 GHz along with GPU overclock of 450 MHz to 650 MHz. For power, Dan uses a power bank to charge his phone and the laptop cooler. And also he has a dedicated game controller, keys mapped using Octopus app. He also has a second phone for watching YouTube, an LG G2 Mini running Lineage OS 14.1, along with Kool-Aid kernel that allowed him to overclock to 1.6 GHz from 1.2 GHz. Definitely, Dan is super high on Android by installing custom ROM and kernel on older smartphones to get every ounce out of them. Custom ROMs are usually faster, and by added custom kernel, Dan is able to get 20 to 30% more CPU GPU performance through overclocking and cooling. Fifth entry comes from Zolika in Serbia. He has customized his UI with hasty widgets that allow him to customize icons, text, background colors, along with Nova Launcher Prime, Zooper widgets, and Oreo icon iPad. He has even made a custom high on Android robot clock with Zooper widget. Zolika uses SwiftKey with a customized keyboard, and Zolika says its built-in translation works great. Lastly but not least, sixth entry comes with Greg All. He has a custom ROM called Hyperdrive ROM installed on AT&T Galaxy S4 running Android 4.4.2. While this is an old ROM, AT&T Galaxy S4 is one of the hardest Samsung phones to root due to its locked bootloader. But Greg was able to use SafeStrap to install the Hyperdrive ROM and successfully get it booting. I am really impressed at the efforts put into older phones like this where there is less development, especially on AT&T models. And I do understand this process can take painstakingly long, as I've actually written a tutorial for the process, so I think Greg definitely deserves to be in our Android Setup Wars. Thanks, Greg. As you can see in some of our examples from our Android Setup Wars, modding Android can really improve the performance of your Android smartphone, whether through rooting, custom ROMs, or apps. The only limit is your creativity. Thanks again for watching the first episode of Android Setup Wars. You can find links to all the mods from the users on my site at highonandroid.com. The next Android Setup Wars will begin as of today. In second episode, we'll be giving away a brand new Pixel 3. The winner of this Android Setup Wars will be picked live, so you know that I have not rigged the contest. Please watch out for a live drawing of the winner in the next few hours. You do not have to be present to win, but I'm just doing it live so you guys know it's fair and square. And that wraps it up for today. If you guys enjoy the Android Setup Wars, be sure to leave a thumbs up. And if you want to win a Pixel 3, make sure you enter Android Setup Wars number 2. All the details will be in the description below. Have a great day. And as always, stay on Android.
Click here to subscribe.